have with me Nishant Arya, who is the ED of the JBM Group and also the Chairman of International Operations, who also incidentally sits on various electric automobility boards of various associations. Nishant, currently we are in a period, very challenging period for the automotive industry. How has the impact been for the JBM in the JBM Group?
See, at JBM, definitely we are catering to all different segments in the industry, whether it's two-wheelers, three-wheelers, passenger vehicles, commercial vehicles, construction equipment, farm equipment. So we have been impacted. Earlier we were operating at about 90%, 95% in different cases. Capacity utilization on a three-shift basis, now we have gone down to about 60-65% with the reduction in volumes, some no production days from customers. And idea is now what we are focusing on is really seeing that how we can keep ourselves very lean, how from our system any kind of fat can be removed, and we are only focusing on our core activities right now. And every plant is trying to see how we are minimizing our inventory levels, focusing on a high level of productivity. And our approach is very frugal at this point. So that is...
Which is understandable. Any specific innovative approach or that thing that you have come across or you have developed, or team has developed during this period that you are implementing now, not only for now, but will come handy in the future as well?
Sure. So a lot of focus is being done on our upcoming programs in the future, on technology, on lightweighting, since this time is available where otherwise when you get into a day-to-day rut, you don't have. So we are working on new technologies of lightweighting, safety, crash, which is coming up with BS6, and that's the need of the hour for the OEMs in the upcoming times. So that's what we are equipping ourselves with, and our R&D and engineering teams are working day and night on those things to really coming out with innovative products, as you said, to give a real solution to the end customer. Otherwise, you are, in most of our cases now, we have moved to art to part kind of a perspective where we are designing and engineering whatever we are manufacturing. So how we understand the total cost of ownership perspective for the end customer, because the customer is not only buying from us, they have warranty costs attached to it, they have the operating costs and maintenance costs attached to it in the future. So we have to manage the whole gamut of activities, and the customer should be very comfortable with us keeping the whole total cost of ownership perspective in place.
And in terms of your investment plans, how much of a kind of rearrangement are you doing, considering that the times that the industry is going through a tough period?
So at a group level, about 150 to 200 crores of investments we are deferring to the upcoming financial years from this financial year, where I really see that we want to utilize the assets which we have now, and we are only investing in the areas where we are committed to programs, because we have to honor our commitments to our customers. And our idea is that definitely things should start improving from July 2020. So prior to that, it's more of a transition from BS4 to BS6. The e-mobility clarity would be coming in. Simultaneously, the government has given a push to liquidity. Stimulus packages are coming in, even though some more support is required for the industry to come back on track. So that is what we are gunning for and looking forward to.
On the electric mobility front, you have made a move already with electric buses.
Right.
Which I understand is about 200 odd buses flying on the roads.
No, so we have about 300 buses plying on the roads of CNG and electric put together right now. And what we are seeing now is that we are delivering our buses to the state of Maharashtra. And what we are seeing is that with the FAME 2 coming in, where there are about 5,500 buses, as things progress, the government has taken a very bold step forward, and public transportation, specifically electric buses, are the primary focus, where the largest allocation of funds has been made, which is for the common man eventually. So that is what will give us a big growth perspective for the upcoming years.
And in terms of investments for that part of your business, how much have you earmarked?
So we have committed about 500 crores of investment in the EV space for new product development, for our facilities, for launching new programs, for battery technology, for charging technology, for vehicle technology, controllers, for key high voltage electricals, power electronics. So we are developing a completely integrated approach for the end customer and giving him an EV ecosystem solution rather than only a product.
So therefore, would I understand that maybe you would try and get into a battery or cell manufacturing also?
Cell maybe in a second phase, but definitely other areas would be coming up in the first phase.
Would you look for any technical alliance, technology alliance for
Definitely, definitely we are quite open, because in this area there is so much of innovation and so much of research happening. Every day we keep getting to hear about new technology. So we are keeping ourselves abreast with new technology and looking to invest in new technology and working with technology partners in different spaces. So it's very collaborative approach.
Electromobility, the nature of the electromobility industry, as I understand, is of a collaborative nature, irrespective of wherever you are in terms of your...
Absolutely.
In terms of...
You see, because no one company can do everything, and yet you want to do everything. So different companies want to collaborate and see that how it can create a win-win solution for the end customer. And everything has to move on to a TCO solution, which is total cost of ownership, rather than purely price or cost.
What's like battery technology? One emerging approach is of battery swapping. Is that something that you are looking at, or do you have a different point of view of that?
No, see, we as a company haven't looked at the battery swapping till now, but I understand that in the industry that's happening. So we personally are gunning and looking at more at fast charging and opportunity charging, flash charging solutions in the longer term, because that's what our organization feels is most appropriate given the product we have. With the 12-meter, 9-meter, and other kind of buses which we are coming up with.
So, and for the overall JBM Group, automotive and non-automotive, what's the split like currently, or is it
majority is automotive only, yeah. Even though we have diversified into other areas, but those businesses are slowly coming up. So, largest part is automotive by far.
And the emerging, the sunshine industry, as it's called, the electromobility. For a time horizon of 5 years or so, by about 2025 or so, how big a business is expected to be?
The time will tell how the government focuses on this, because you know a lot will depend on the policy framework. Like I'll give you a small example of solar. So solar, the government started with 1 megawatt and 5 megawatt projects in 2009-10. In a span of 9 to 10 years, today we are sitting at almost 30 gigawatt of installation in the country. That has only happened because the government has had that right policy framework, and our Honorable Prime Minister gave it that kind of support, and he believed in that technology. That's why India became the hub for the International Solar Alliance also. Similar things is what we expect in case of electric mobility. So I think in the next couple of years, in a year or 2 years, a lot of clarity will come in that where the government is headed. Then, but I personally feel this is the way to go, and that's where the country would move in eventually. And we as an organization are committed to that. So that's why we want to be a part of the whole transition journey from the beginning.
Any areas or any approaches you think should be adopted for a proper transition and a timely transition to electric mobility?
I think like in different countries, they have incentivized zero emission zones. So that is one thing good for heritage sites and other cultural sites around those. We should be using e-mobility so that the monuments are not getting spoiled. Thirdly, like in Amsterdam and other countries, you see that they are giving free parking for e-vehicles. So the public charging infrastructure is very important. How you are able to give a holistic approach with the power, charging, battery, vehicle, and the customers are able to see an integrated solution with the operating cycle becomes very essential, with the funding, startups, how are they involved, because they are coming up with good technology. So the whole ecosystem has to operate very efficiently for the industry to deliver the solution for the end customers. So that is something which the government needs to institutionalize. A lot of work is being done in that direction. I think in the coming years, a year or 2 years, a lot of things would span out very clearly.
Sure. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
For sparing our time.
Sure. Thank you.
There you heard Nishant Arya of the JBM Group, one of the key players in the Indian automotive industry, sharing his views on how the current slowdown is impacting the business, and the step that the company is taking, as well as how the preparations to tap the opportunity in the future in the electric mobility arena. How an Indian company is planning to take steps to tap the growth opportunity there. Thanks for watching this interview. Do keep watching our YouTube channel for more such interviews with industry representatives. Goodbye.